division has really appealed to the fans over the last several years, and this man has made himself undeniable, gets his first title shot in the UFC tonight.
You know, John, these guys are small, but I believe that is one of the most skilled divisions in the entire UFC, and this gentleman has really separated himself from the pack. He has done everything necessary to put himself right on the verge of doing something special. He believes that he's going to get it done tonight. Every part of him believes that he's the best. Now he has to go out and show.
No man should weigh 125 pounds. I mean, let's be honest, man. That is a package of skill and will and grit that looks a whole lot like a future champion. Here he is, my 2023 Fighter of the Year and the undisputed UFC flyweight champion, Alexandre Pantoja. Pro debut at 17 years of age in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. Finally breaks through to win the undisputed UFC title at 33 years of age. He is as watchable and as well-rounded as any fighter in the sport. And in advance of his first title defense at our fighter meeting, he said, now the focus is getting my pound-for-pound due. I know I'm the best flyweight in the world. I'm out to prove that again tonight. But I want to show the masses that I can be the pound-for-pound king, and he might just be that guy. Well, it is the venue in which every UFC athlete hopes to one day compete, and we are now ready to go from Madison Square Garden here in New York City. Our tale of the tape for this flyweight championship fight. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. It's time! Five rounds for the undisputed UFC flyweight championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, presenting the challenger, Demetrious, Mighty Mouse Johnson! And now, introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC champion of the world, Alexandre the Cannibal Pantoja!
Herb Dean, our referee, ready for this fight. One.
Ready. Good.
As good a combination of speed and technique as there is in the lower weight classes, Demetrious Johnson back at it here tonight. And when you have as many weapons as this guy does, very difficult for the opposition to try to game plan and figure out what's coming back your way. Demetrious Johnson looking to get off to another fast start tonight. All right, half guard now. Not a fighter you want in half guard against you for the bottom fighter. What does he need to do?
He needs to secure his underhook. He's got to be fighting for underhook. One of the most key things you can do as a bottom fighter stuck in half guard is try to frame. You frame and push your opponent away from you. By pushing him away from you, he will then want to come back into you.
Right.
It's like when I push you back, you want to go forward. So as he comes forward, hand goes off the face, let it slip into an underhook, build up to your elbow, then go chase your single leg. This is high-level grappling, John, from a Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt named Daniel Cormier.
Woo!
Gotta be careful here.
Inside the closed guard. Looks like he might attempt the guillotine now. Oh, that guillotine choke is tight. Oh, so now he bails on the submission.
He bailed, and rightfully so. You keep the dominant position. Great job. Very smart fighter we got there.
All right, great position for him here. He's got the full mount. See if he can get that ground and pound going.
Oh, he's got to get it going, but he can't rush. A lot of times, guys get into full mount and they rush. They get nervous. They're like, oh, my goodness, I'm winning. Reality is, you're winning, but it can change in a matter of seconds because then they can be gone. He's got to drop his hips, be really heavy at the opponent's base, and then just start to work. Make the opponent give his back so that he can try to get his chokes off or find great ground and pound, but very patient ground and pound from such a dominant position.
Pantoja's right back to the full mount.
Big ground and pound. This is a terrible position.
He's having his way with him here. Well, this is a tough fighter to buck off. Very good pressure and work here by Pantoja. Pretty good ground and pound by him here. He told us on Thursday he needed to be more effective in these situations. Certainly effective tonight.
Many people have gone away from this style of fighting. This man has embraced it, and you are seeing why. He's one of the best that we've seen do it in a long time.
A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. Under 2 minutes to go in our first round. Well, he's worked very hard on this part of his game, and these ground strikes are really starting to take their toll. Making all these shots count. All right, north-south position here. We'll see if the crowd can be mature about this, DC. Well, hard to win fights in mixed martial arts from the bottom, but nice work here in that position by Johnson.
Win the scramble! Win the scramble!
Strong reversal there.
Inside the closed guard.
And he's gonna try to find ways to pass and move to a submission.
Under a minute now to go in the round.
He passes the half.
All right, right into side control. Upper body strength figures to be put to good use here.
Yes, absolutely. And you gotta look for his opponent to turn back into him. He should chase guillotine, but the opponent turns to the opposite side. He can take his back, throw his hooks in, try to choke, or flatten him out and just go for the finish. Nice loop and punch. Beautiful body kick.
20 seconds left. And that one certainly found the target. Seconds. 5 minutes in the books.
All right. Listen, breathe, relax. I need you to get out there and keep this fight on your feet. I want you to avoid that takedown.
All right, a lot of high-level striking action in that last round. Daniel, take us through it, if you would.
Tit for tat. Who has the best chin? It seemed as though they were looking for that answer. Both guys took risk. What a fantastic round.
You ready to fight? Ready.
All right, round two. All right, so here we go with our next round, and there was a lot for him to like defensively in the previous round, almost as if he's one or two steps ahead of his opponent in terms of seeing the strike before it. Huge strike lands there, DC.
He landed that massive shot. Now he needs to try to find the next shot, the follow-up shot, that will finish the fight. He's setting up a sub attempt. Great job maintaining position there. You never want to lose position to chase a submission. Yes, smart adjustment, yep.
Continues to apply pressure here in half guard. All right, we'll see if he can apply pressure inside his opponent's guard here, DC. Well, working pretty effectively from the top here. Nice ground and pound by DJ.
He's very accurate in the ground and pound, and it's showing because he's landing so consistently.
Demetrious going to work here from guard. Nice combination there. Everything he throws is with fight-ending intentions. Fighter trying to pass here. Ooh, but gets denied.
Gets denied. Great job. Great recognition of seeing what your opponent is trying to do.
Strike to the body, really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection, and these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds. Swing and a big miss by Johnson.
Guillotine jump.
Oh, favoring position over submission.
Very smart decision. You never want to value the submission over keeping dominant position.
Just over 3 minutes to go. Really doing a nice job getting these shots home on the ground.
I mean, way to stay aware and stay safe defensively.
Johnson's in half guard now.
Now he's going full mount. Changing the position.
Not there yet, but might get the submission here shortly. Oh, good ground and pound here. And there it is, another strike gets through on the ground. Lands a strike now from the bottom. Nice work there by DJ.
Nice defense. Nice shot there by the champ.
Oh, great ground strike there. And now, blood is a factor. Under 2 minutes here to go in round two. Relentless pressure from the top by Pantoja. A lot of top pressure being applied here. Ground and pound, the hammer Mark Coleman would be proud.
Well-placed shot, right to the swell. Great job recognizing where he's hurt and going back to it. It looks like the official may need to call in the ringside physician. Oh, he's got to be careful there, yep.
Might get the TKO here. Dominant position for him here, full mount. If you're the bottom fighter, better start moving those hips, DC.
Oh, you got to start moving those hips. What you should do initially, right, is start to push at the knees. Push at the hips, create some distance, shrimp, and try to recollect half guard. Half guard sucks, but it's much better than being mounted fully by your opponent.
Johnson's cut is getting worse here. Man, is that bleeding. Pretty good work with the ground and pound here by Pantoja. Oh, staying busy from top position. He lands another ground strike there. Drops down inside the now closed guard of his opponent.
Let's see how patient he is as he attacks a submission or big ground and pound.
Oh, lands with the ground and pound strike.
Another strike gets through from the top position. Great submission defense on display tonight.
Oh, nice hammer fist there by Pantoja. And the horn sounds on round two. All right, so the fighters head back to the stools, and hopefully this fight can continue. That is a severe cut. We'll see if the cut man can do some good work here. All right, back to the stools we go, and it's starting to look like a second mouth on his cheek.
Yeah, it looks terrible. I mean, the guy is getting hit with big shots, one big enough to open up a nasty cut on his cheek. While it's in a better spot, it still is very difficult to deal with.
Like, if he absorbs another strike on that cheek, he might actually be able to eat through that cut on his cheek. I'm just saying.
He's got a big mouth.
Here we go, third round of this championship fight. Johnson's face would have to be classified as a mess. Cut on his cheek, and it's only getting worse. Oh, what a connection by him there. His opponent could be out of here soon, DC.
He's almost done. I mean, when you get hit with a shot like that, you don't know whether to run, hide, grab, or wrestle. He's confused.
Pantoja's trying for a submission here. Oh, somehow, some way he got out.
These guys are back and forth, and submission defense wins this transition.
Oh, looks like that submission's almost locked in.
Starting to get pretty deep here.
Oh, that's gotta be it. Oh, how good is that as he gets out?
That is great submission defense, keeping everything short and not allowing his opponent to get the submission victory.
Oh, man, another strike gets through, and now things are critical. We got a lot of blood, folks.
Good jab there by the champion.
Good work from the top here by Pantoja.
Great defense by the defensive fighter. You can't take all those unanswered strikes. They don't have to be that damaging.
Yep.
You just gotta move.
While the crowd continues to react with every passing land, but if you're the referee or even the corner, somebody's gotta get involved, I would say.
Somebody's gotta do something. It's getting very uncomfortable to watch this. And as the crowd gets excited, there's also a little bit of that. I don't want to see any more going on in their reactions.
Oh, good technique there. He's got the triangle choke locked in. Trying to guard pass here. Not today.
No, it ain't happening. Good job understanding the transition. Good job by the champ there. Sliding back up.
All right, feet on the hips here.
Very good. Keep going.
Well, the ground and pound is there once again. Strong work here by Pantoja. Oh, and another punch on the ground gets through. May need some defense here. Oh, huge pop from the crowd as the fighters get back up to their feet. I mean, we were out with a good grappling match, but these fighters came to see knockouts.
Yeah, the fans came to see them knock each other out. That's what they're going to get. All the grappling was beautiful.
All right, pausing the action here, and if you're the referee, you had to do it, right? The cut on the cheek, not in a terrible place, but a whole lot of blood coming down.
And every time he gets hit, there's just blood flying out of that cut. It's a massive cut on the cheek, and the swelling that is starting to form on this guy's face is like nothing I've seen for a while.
Yeah, doctor not here to make friends. He has no choice but to stop the fight. We have blood on our notes. Goes into the books as a TKO via doctor stoppage. All right, so that'll do it. TKO via doctor stoppage. And at some point, the doctor has no choice but to save the athlete from themselves. Too much damage to that cheek.
Absolutely. I mean, all these strikes just kept landing directly on his cheek. You know, it got the point to be so bad that once the doctor was brought into the octagon, he had no choice but to call this fight. And very rarely do we agree, but right now we agree with the decision.
The official decision is in. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, the doctor has called a stop to this fight. Declaring the winner by TKO and still the undisputed UFC flyweight champion of the world.
All right, so there he is, the still UFC flyweight champion of the world.